What is the difference between acute and chronic pain? Most people, including physicians, think they're the same thing, that the only difference is their duration. Acute pain lasts a few hours, days, or weeks, and chronic pain lasts months or years. Although this is true, the duration is not the main difference between acute and chronic pain. Acute pain is a symptom, while chronic pain is a condition. The treatments that work for acute pain may not work for chronic pain, and in fact, some treatments that are very effective for acute pain may make chronic pain worse. So, let's talk about acute and chronic pain today. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to provide medical advice. If you have a condition that causes pain, please talk to your doctor. This video is only for educational purposes. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. Acute pain is what we feel when we cut the skin, a burn, a toothache from a cavity, an appendicitis, or a bone fracture. Acute pain is a symptom that there is an injury, a disease, and there is a dangerous situation that we must avoid. Acute pain diminishes with time as the body starts healing the wound or the damage that was caused by the inflammation. During acute pain, the body tries to avoid movement around the painful area. So if there is a broken bone, the muscles around it will get tense and the person will avoid any movement to protect the area. When a person feels acute pain, many areas of the brain are also activated, like the areas of fear, anxiety, and worry. That is a natural reaction of the mind to respond to a dangerous situation. So, with time, depending on the type of injury, the body will heal in a few days or weeks. Usually by 3 months, the wound will be closed. The brain does not need to continue activating the areas of fear and anxiety, and the person will not feel any more pain. So, why do some people have ongoing persistent chronic pain for many months or years after an injury or damage has healed? So, by definition, chronic pain is any pain that lasts longer than the expected period of healing, which is around 3 months. The pain will be persistent despite the appropriate treatments. Any person who is starting to develop chronic pain needs to be assessed by a healthcare professional who is knowledgeable and understands the neuroscience of pain. Well, at this point, around 3 months, it is really important to assess the patient for risks of developing chronic pain. And if the professional finds that the patient is at high risk of developing chronic pain, send the patient to the proper kind of therapy. I have another video that I explain what are the factors that put a person at a higher risk of developing chronic pain. And I talk about what we can do to prevent acute pain from becoming chronic pain. So, what is chronic pain? It is a condition. It's a disease itself. Chronic pain is a malfunction of the pain system. It's an ongoing condition that does not mean that there is a damage or harm anywhere in the body. Chronic pain is pain. It is real pain. It is annoying and unpleasant. Chronic pain is the disease itself, not a symptom of another disease. And chronic pain is when the alarm system of the body is making noise, loud noise, but there is no fire, no breaking, it's just that noise. So to summarize, acute pain is a symptom of an injury or a disease, and chronic pain is the disease. Acute pain needs time to heal. Usually by 3 months, everything is healed. And chronic pain is pain that persists beyond the healing time, which is usually 3 months. Acute pain needs short period of rest. Chronic pain gets worse with rest. Acute pain gets better with strong painkillers like opioids, but chronic pain is not eliminated with opioids. And in some people, opioids can make it worse due to opioid-induced hyperalgesia. See my other video about this. In acute pain, it is easy to find a cause, like a broken bone or nerve damage. In chronic pain, the doctors and the patients spend years trying to find out what is wrong, and they usually get mixed messages or contradicting opinions. In conclusion, pain is a sensation that can be very confusing. We tend to think if there is a lot of pain, there is an injury, but this is not true. The amount of pain is usually not a good thermometer for the amount of injury we have. Well, if you like this video, give your thumbs up here and share with your friends using this button here. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.